Hey everybody, this is TeaStrands. Welcome back. This is episode 7, I believe. And today we are going to do a few minor things, and I'll give you a hint here. Yeah, I found a slime chunk and I marked it out right here. And there might be a downside here because I dug out a space below level 40 already, and they've been spawning in one corner, so they might be to a chunk to the side. But you know, I'm gonna go ahead and show you what I got here. I've done a lot and a lot and lot, 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 lots, lots and lots and lots of digging, and you'll see here. So all these are just fences for water canals that are just about ready, and I got my water ready and all. I'm gonna need my tools, but you'll just see how extensively long it is as I run down it and never reach the end. Right, just kidding. Here it is. But yeah, so okay, don't do that to me, please. So here's the platform I got laid out. I believe it's on like level 36, something like that. But it's all ready to have water canals put around it. And I started out here with signs because it didn't occur to me to use the fences. And the lighting is kind of bad, but I'm going to replace all these torches with glowstone because right now mobs can spawn. You can see right there at the BL, that's the block light, the current block light. And that's 8, and that's exactly what they need to spawn. And that's the lowest it gets. So once it's replaced with glowstone, it'll be okie dokie, just fine, hunky dory. So I'm gonna go ahead and flatten this off and work on the water currents a little bit, but need dirt. There we can go. Right. So basically, if you don't know how slime farms work, you gotta find the slime chunk, you know. And this is 17 by 17, actually. On accident, but it was too late by the time I had already dug out the canals. I just didn't really care. Chunks are 16 by 16. Once you find a slime that has spawned, and it was in the ravine up here, it was like around here, I believe. But once you find the slime that spawned, you go into that chunk, and basically, as long as you're below level 40, you make a platform, and I'm on level 33. You can see my Y coordinates. And they'll all spawn on here as long as you're 20 blocks away. It doesn't matter what lighting it is, I'm just trying to keep mobs from spawning down here. Let me check my difficulty. Perfect. All right, so basically they'll spawn, they'll hop around in a straight direction because they don't turn unless you're there. I read up on the wiki right before this actually. So basically when they spawn in facing a random direction, so let's randomize myself. And they'll just jump and jump and jump, and they'll fall into the water streams, right? And these water streams are going to be pushing them, right? And oh, I think I'm going the wrong way. Yeah, so it'll be pushing them this way. It'll curve them, and it'll push them all the way up to the surface. So I'm going to go ahead and start the water currents back here, and you can see my design. Let me grab this guy real quick too. So when they come down here, unless they're little, they'll get sucked into one of these. All right, and we'll have one guy right here. So as you can see, what's gonna happen here is they're gonna get pushed over into this and pushed up onto this, and they'll be caught by this water current that's being held back by the signs, as you can see. So they don't even have to jump. Actually, when slimes are in water, they're sucked to the ground. They sink in water. It's what they do. So they'll be stuck to the ground, so like this. I'm not even pushing W or anything. And they'll just be pushed like so. So that's how that works. And I got a little mixed up here, as you can see, because I ran out of signs and came back with the good idea. And this whole thing's gonna be a mess because every time I update these, they close. Which is terrible. Can't believe that Mojang did that, because I don't recall that ever happening. There we go. So all the water's connected all the way around except for on this side. And I'm gonna keep recording just for this part. But once I start going up that really, 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 really long staircase that took me like 2 hours to dig out, I'm probably just gonna do it all off camera because nobody wants to watch that. Oh crap! There we go, everybody. And if you don't understand how I'm doing this, I'm just making a water source right here, right there in this guy, and I pull the water right out of him, and that makes it so you don't have to go back and forth from an infinite stream, because you got one, you know? There we go. And now, don't update. Good. Good. Oh, I forgot this guy right over here. That could have been a little fatal. Not really, but kind of. Alright, so we got the sides done. And this is going to be a little touchy. Oh, crap. There we go. So I'm going to do that the whole way up as soon as I show you what I'm doing here around the corner bend, because it's a little more complicated. So basically what I'm doing here is I'm placing one here and one back here. I tested this out before, but as you can see, it pushes directly to the center of this, and that's exactly what I want. So let me grab some more water from this stream right here, and I'll show you the second part of the curve, because you never know, man. A lot of people go to Let's Plays that they've seen before for tutorials, so I just want to make sure everybody knows what's going on. So this guy's not going to have one right here either, because I'll just push him all this way. I want him to get pushed into that corner. And yeah. So I'm going to pretty much just do that the whole way up. And then I'll find my way back down here and I'll write it myself and commentate while doing so. So I'll see you then. Alright, all done. So once they get pushed up to this spot, I'm just hoping they just jump up and hop around. It's not like they can go back down, so even if they're down here, I'll just kill them. So yeah, and since I have fence gates, might as well fence off where I'm going to have my animals. Yeah. So I might as well tell you what my plans are for the animals. So as you can see here, I replaced the cobble with grass in here. So slimes, obviously. I'm planning on having cows right here because they're not the least annoying, but they're the most bearable, I guess, which is kind of contradicted what I just said. But here I'm going to have an egg farm / chicken farm, I guess. Well, I might do like chicken farm and then egg farm. I don't know. We'll see. But then I'm going to have sheep right here because this is about as far as it gets without going into the back rooms right there, and then pigs right there, and my mob evader or the mob trap coming up into here, my mob grinder right there. So that's what I'm planning for that. I'm gonna go ride the slime up water slide. You can't really call it a water slide because it goes up, but I guess I can call it what I want. I hope this doesn't screw things up. And Geronimo! Alright, how did that do anything bad? Anything bad at all? Oh, go away, go away, go away. Alright, sweet. Okay, so here I am. I am a slime. Blah, 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 and spawn. I'm gonna hop, hoppity, hop. Oh, I'm in water. I can't swim up at all. So I'm just going to be completely immobile and see if I get stuck on anything or, I don't know, just can't go up, basically. And I'm just hoping for the best here. So far, so good. Yeah. This actually took a really long time. I've been thinking about it lately, and I really just hope that I can continue making videos with this much effort into the school year, this upcoming school year, because I've mentioned it before, but I am 16 years old and I'm going to be a junior in high school this upcoming year. And you know, if this really does take off at all, I'm probably not going to take AP Lang because that would take up all of my free time, like all of it. And take a senior year most likely because I'm getting all my classes out of the way this year anyways. It's going to be easy peasy. That's what I'm hoping for. But yeah, here comes the. I haven't moved at all, myself at all. And here comes the exit. So here I am. I'm a slime. I'm free. Oh my gosh. I thought I would drown. And here I am. I'll be hopping around here, making fat noises until Mr. TeaStrands comes to kill you. So yeah, that's what I've done for the past 2, 3 hours, I guess. Isn't that right, Chuckles? Weren't you bored out of your mind? Let's go for a walk. All right. So what was I gonna do here? I think I'm gonna do the most awkward combination for a Let's Play episode ever and do my slime farm and go to the Nether in the same episode. Just to be unique, you know? And I'm not gonna harvest that for a while. But I'm not entirely sure where to put the Nether portal, so all right, Chuckles, teleport in here. Chocolate blue. Okay, where'd you go, Chuckles? Come on, no, inside. 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 Good boy. Sit. All right, so need my obsidian. I'm gonna need one of these and a flint. My inventory is a mess, but I'm glad I can find stuff in here. All right. I think I'm just gonna put it in the mine shaft for now. You stay feathers, or feathers sun. All right. So got this. Got this. Bring a stack of cobbler too. And chocolate boo. Okay. Let's just put it in here because it's a cool place to put it. All right. Right here. I kind of want to do the full thing, but I want to save obsidian too. Ooh. Okay, I guess I'll just do the full effect on top at least. All right, here we go into the Nether. Oh yeah, this is blue because Nether portals lag a lot. And it's a feature of Optifine. I think it looks cooler though. Oh, hurts my eyes. All right, here we go though. I'll probably take it off eventually, like maybe after this episode, just to make Minecraft look a little more natural, you know. But with the Nether here, let's see if I get lucky and spawn right by another fortress. I tend to do that a lot. No, I didn't, but you know what? This is actually a kind of nice spot because ghasts aren't going to be shooting at me to begin with. I'm going to let some chunks load. I'll get back to you. Alright, so I let the chunks load, obviously, and I also just built a little cobblestone. I don't even know what to call that. It's 4 in the morning. But yeah, I'm not going to do this on camera, but I'm going to be collecting tons and tons and tons and tons and tons of glowstone. But to make this episode a little interesting. Oh! Come here! Come here, all of you! You! Look at all that glowstone right there. That's a lot. Heck yeah. There's a bunch of mushrooms too. So right now I'm just gonna explore some, but I'm gonna try my best to never really harvest on camera, because that's like one of the most boring things Let's Players can do. Let's Players. Yeah. Oh, you not aggroed at me? Ow. Okay, so I'm gonna make you aggroed at me here in a second after I look around a little bit. Because I'm going to kill every single one of you. Oh. Getting little spikes of lag. But you know what? This is probably the coolest Nether terrain I've gotten. To be quite honest. I'm gonna need to go on a hunt for a Nether fortress, though. 'Cause I usually get lucky and spawn right by him, like almost all the time, I'm telling you. Okay. So I'm just gonna kind of remember where this is. I'll remember where to go from here, but this is 14, negative 100. Alright. So don't fight in soul sand. See any gas? I'm playing on hard. Where are all the gas, man? Oh, Nether Fortress. It just rendered. You see that? Heck yeah. I'm gonna make a bridge over there, most likely. Heck yeah. And my portal is just under all this stuff, so it won't take long to get there at all from it, actually. Or, you know, I could just destroy that portal while I'm in here and go over there and build one of my own, and I should teleport back to the same spots. I believe you have to be, like, 800 blocks apart, something like that. I'm not even sure, but let's kill everything. Come on. Yeah. You're all in slow sand. Ha 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 ha. Ha. Ow. I swear there are more. Oh, yeah. There's quite a bit more. All of you at once. Yeah, let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Yeah. Anyone else? Yeah, I need the experience. Come on, gas. I hear ya. Come on. Let's go. Let's go. Let's make the Nether a little more interesting. Yeah, that's right. You're afraid. You're afraid of TeaStrands. He's the most friendly name ever, but he'll kick your ass. Yeah, that's right. Oh, crap. Okay, I'm dying. But I'm still going to take on all of them. You still aggro at me? Heck yeah, you are. Bring it. Oh, I hear more. I hear more. You hear me over there? Come on. Get over here. You just going to growl? It's like, oh, arrow pierced me in the butthole. Oh, no. Better not do anything about it. All right, Nether bust. So far, almost bust, but at least I'm killing pigmen. Need the experience. So, yeah. Come on. Come on. Like I said, this is usually my fallback when I have no idea what to do. I hope that doesn't make it a little less appealing. But, you know, I think fighting things that usually kill people are fun. I have done that twice now. I'm gonna put obsidian over that hole. Oh, never mind. It's three wide. It's way too expensive. Oh yeah, bring it, gas. Bring it. What you gonna do? Huzzah! Ow. Okay, are you coming for me? Ow. Okay, let's eat. Okay, bring it, bring it, bring it. Come on. Where are you going? Sound like my sister. Alright, so I'm gonna get on out of here. I'll come back between this episode and next episode and get a bunch of glowstone. I'm gonna go kill this guy. Hopefully I can get a ghast here. You're stuck. What you gonna do? Ha 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 ha. Ha ha. No ghast here. What a bummer. Alright, so I'm gonna get out of here. Alright, so far so good. I mean, I really want to get to the end more than anything. That's what I really want to do. But that's not going to be happening for a while here, you know? And let me jump on out of here. But overall goals for the future, I guess I'll go over some. Oh, no, no, no! No. Oh, where'd you come from? Okay. So basically, like I said, I want this castle to end up being at least over the 100 height limit. And that would be really nice because it hasn't really risen much, but I just feel I need to get more setup before I do anything, you know? And let's see if I got any slimes. Cuz that would be cool, even though it'd probably take them an hour to travel up that little thing. I really hope it wasn't off in the corner. Like I said, if it was though, I guess I would just have to move over the pad and then hook it up to that staircase. Thank God I don't have to like move the whole staircase, you know. Oh, my bad. so I'm gonna go ahead and block this off with a few blocks of dirt. Okay. There we go. There we go, and bam. And you know what I still haven't finished? You'll never believe it, but I still haven't finished this walkway. It's just by a few blocks, and I think I have stone sitting in my chest at home. But yeah, I haven't. Wow. Alright, so goals for the future. Make this entrance look epic, and if not epic, make it look like a mouth is eating me. Have that mob system I was talking about, the 31 by 31 5-layer mob trap, so it's going to be 31 by 31 square with mobs pushing everything to the middle. Like, look at this look at this block. Pretend that's 31 by 31. It'll all push to the middle, then there will be another block on top of it, and they'll all push to the middle. Another block on top of that, 5 layers, and it'll all push to the middle and make them take fall damage before they reach the surface somehow. I honestly don't really care how that's going to go down, because it'll all be underground and it won't matter if it looks ugly or not. But I'm going to have them all come up here. I'm going to separate the spiders from the single mobs, so I'll have like spiders right here being held in with certain spider design, and then all the single mobs held in right here, just with like a casing and showing their feet. And that'll be my mob grinding for my experience. I might hook it up, might get a spawner somewhere too as well, but I really don't care too much for spawners. I mean, building big mob traps isn't a really big deal for me. And I guess my next thing on the agenda, though, is to get a bunch of animals into these guys. And thankfully enough, I have a bunch of wheat ready to be harvested. So I'm going to go try to grab a few cows. I actually saw my first cow on this world while I was chopping down some wood for those fences down there. He was right over there. Let's go see if he's still there. All right, guys, so I just looked at the recording times of my episode so far, and it looks like I'm over 20 minutes in, and I don't really like carrying on past 20 minutes too far, so I'm gonna go ahead and let it go off here and let you guys go. But thank you for watching. If you liked my soon to be effective slime farm, hopefully soon to be effective slime farm, and if you like my little trip to the Nether and those two arrow shots to that gas, because I thought that was epic and I just said it silently in my head, go ahead and like the video and subscribe for more. Alright, and thank you guys for watching. I'm gonna finish getting all this wheat. Oh, faster. Alright, thank you guys for watching, and TeaStrands out.